Very warm welcome to St. Mary's and to our service for the 10th of January, the first Sunday after Epiphany, a day when we remember in particular when Jesus came to the River Jordan to be baptized by John. After our service at about 10:30, we're going to have a Zoom coffee meeting to which all are invited, and the details will be given below. Do hope you can come to that. And we begin with an opening song, His Name Shall Be.
Mercy found us here. Glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the angels sing. He came to tell the Father's love, His goodness and His grace. To show the brightness of His smile, the glory of His face. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, your children sing. His name shall be called Wonderful. Burdens and to give a glorious gift. So glory in the highest, and on the earth be peace. Glory to God, the world will sing. His name shall be called Wonderful. everlasting Father, Prince of Peace, for all eternity. Oh, His name shall be. Oh, His name shall be.
We meet to celebrate the coming of Christ into the world. The Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld His glory. And we say our prayer of preparation together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Because God was merciful, He saved us through the water of rebirth and the renewing power of the Holy Spirit. But through sin, we have fallen away from our baptism. So let us return to the Lord and renew our faith in His promises by confessing our sins in penitence. You raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. You bring pardon and peace to the broken in heart. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. You make one by your Spirit the torn and divided. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May God our Father forgive you your sins and bring you to the fellowship of His table with His saints forever. Amen. And the prayer of the church for this Sunday. Heavenly Father, at the Jordan you revealed Jesus as your Son. May we recognize Him as our Lord and know ourselves to be your beloved children through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. And now Georgie will lead us in our Gospel reading.
Hear the Gospel of our Lord according to St Mark. Glory to you, O Lord. And so John the Baptist appeared in the wilderness, preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The whole Judean countryside and all of the people of Jerusalem went out to him, confessing their sins. They were baptized by him in the river Jordan. John wore clothing made of camel's hair with a leather belt round his waist and ate locusts and wild honey. And this was his message. After me comes the one more powerful than I, the straps of whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit. At that time, Jesus came from Nazareth in Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. Just as Jesus was coming up out of the water, he saw heaven being torn open and the Spirit descending on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my Son, whom I love. With you I am well pleased."
May I speak in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I want you just to imagine yourself for a minute, fast asleep in the middle of the night. You're all cozy with the duvet wrapped around you, and it's really, really dark in your room. When suddenly, in the depths or from the depths of your sleep, you are awoken by the lights going on, blaring in your face, and this voice saying to you, "Wake up, it's time to get out of bed." Well, that's kind of been my experience these last few days. since I decided to tell my husband that I'd like to join him for his morning run. It's felt to me like the middle of the night, and I'm really not a morning person, but every single morning I've had the light go on and this wonderful voice calling me to wake up. And I think that's something similar to the opening of what Mark's gospel is like. You see, Mark's gospel feels very dramatic. It is like a light being switched on. And particularly as we see John the Baptist's ministry start, where he bursts into the world of the most surprised Jews to challenge them, to tell them to turn their lives around, to wake up from their dreams, from their nightmares, and turn away from those things which are disrupting the peace of God in the world. And then John baptizes them symbolically, just as they would have thought about when they were going through the Exodus, when they remembered their history of journeying through those waters of the Red Sea and leaving Egypt behind. John, through these waters of baptism, says to them symbolically, you know, leave those things of Egypt behind and come into the freedom of a new life. And John says that just as he baptizes them with water, there is one to come who will baptize them with the Holy Spirit. This is the one that they have been waiting for, the promise that they've sat and lived with for a long, long time. And John says, wake up. God is about to speak into your lives. Are you ready? And it happens here at this scene where Jesus appears. And he just stands with those crowds of ordinary people and then heads into the waters himself to be baptized by John. And interestingly, this is one of the few places in scripture where we see the three persons of the Trinity named together in one place, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And as Jesus went into a river to get baptized, you'll probably be quite aware that in the Church of England, we don't often go outside into rivers to baptize people, probably because it's a bit too cold to do that. And, you know, we'd need to find rivers near our churches and so on. But instead, we have a font within the church where, as a priest, it's an amazing privilege to baptize infants, children, people of all ages. Using that font in the church. And I wonder if you've ever thought to yourself about the position of a font in the church, because in most older church buildings, you will find that the font is usually placed by the entrance into the building, whatever that entrance is. And the reason for that is that primarily baptism is a sacrament of initiation. And so by placing that at the entrance to the church, particularly thinking of it historically, it was almost a reminder to people as you walk into the building that this is perhaps the way to get in. This is the way that you become part of the family of God. And as I think about that, I was reminded recently of a story of a priest who was at a funeral, and the family were rather panicked at the funeral because the person who had died had not been baptised. And so they asked the priest, you know, would you baptise this person? And of course, that throws up all sorts of theological and pastoral issues. And the priest didn't baptise the person who'd already deceased. But what's more significant, I think, is that it makes us think about what was the family's understanding about the meaning of baptism, and perhaps even more significantly, what would their understanding of Christianity be? And here's the thing, as we hold all of that in mind, and the thing that I find really fascinating as we think about and consider this passage, Jesus didn't need to get baptized to be initiated into the church. Jesus didn't need to be baptized to become a Christian. And so what is it in this passage that reveals something of God's heart to us? What is it that this passage says? What is it that is important about the fact that Jesus was baptized? Why was Jesus baptized? What does that say to us in our lives? You see, Jesus didn't come to earth to change the mind of God about humanity. You know, God's mind could never be changed. But Jesus came to earth to change the mind of humanity about God. And so here in this passage, we see Jesus go into the waters to be baptized. And baptism, the word translates literally as taking a bath. They would have understood baptism as a way of purification to then having an encounter with God. So a way of preparation to kind of say, here I am ready, God, to encounter you and your presence. Here I am ready for you to break into my world. So that's kind of what they would have thought they were doing, what they would have seen Jesus perhaps doing at that point. But something really significant happens. And so just as Jesus is coming up out of the water, we hear or read there that the heaven is torn open. The Spirit descends like a dove, and Jesus hears the voice of God saying, "You are my child, you are my beloved, with you I am well pleased." There is something about Jesus' baptism that is all to do with identity. You see, baptism for Jesus meant identifying with God, with God's life, with God's vision and purpose for his life. This is the gospel that changes lives. God breaking into the world and saying, "You are mine, you are loved, with you I am well pleased." And so if that's what baptism meant for Jesus, and if we are in Christ, and we are, and Christ is within us, and Christ is, then is this not also, to some degree, what baptism can mean for us? You see, Christ is not some distant historical figure about whom we have a certain set of beliefs that we are asked to confess. But Christ is present. Christ is a reality, alive here and now, the one who invites us to experience God through him. And Jesus' life reveals the mystery of God's love and grace. And included in this love and grace is the capacity for us to know that same truth for ourselves and for all of creation. What we see in him, what we discover in him, we need to see and discover within ourselves. This, I think, is in part what it means to follow Christ. And we know something about what it is to follow Christ and to know Christ through our experiences of God, through our personal realizations of who Christ is for us. And we know that because God has called us on a journey and we step out on that journey with God. And so in knowing whose he is and who he is, Jesus was free to live the life that he was born to experience. In knowing who we are and whose we are then free to live the life we were born to experience. Jesus' baptism, what he experienced, tells us something about what it means to be a human being in relationship with God. What's available to us through our relationship with God. And you see, that is all to do with our identity. From the moment a child has a consciousness about who they are and can form opinions and identities about themselves, we start listening to narratives around us. And we form our identity through childhood and adolescence and into adulthood, often based on those narratives. And sometimes those narratives are false. But this is the greatest thing that you could know. These words that you hear in this passage today. God says that you are loved. God says that you are his child. And God says, "In you I am well pleased." Is this not the message that the world needs to hear? This is the greatest gospel of all, a God that loves us unconditionally. And so baptism, I think, is given as a sign that Christ has changed the narrative of our lives. We can see ourselves differently. We can see ourselves or start to glimpse ourselves through the eyes of God. And sometimes that is a journey that takes a lifetime. But actually, we want to be people that live and discover that truth of God at work in our lives. And there's also something in that about us being called to be the body of Christ, that as we discover something of our identity, that we live that out, and why we are called to love others so that they say it too can experience their own identity and realization of that identity through Christ. Do you see yourself as God's beloved this morning? I wonder, when you look in the mirror, if you realize that that face looking back at you is one whom God delights in. This is who you are. This is whose you are. And it's probably the greatest gift that we could ever give to another person, to our children, to our friends, to our family, to our community, to know that you are loved. And so whenever you see a font when you enter a church building, again, perhaps even when you see a river, I want to say to you, be reminded first and foremost that that represents that you are loved of God first and foremost. And through our baptism, which is an occurrence that doesn't just take place once, but over and over again, that you know you are loved and find your identity in Christ. Amen.
We affirm our faith in the words of the Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Now Jasmine leads us in our intercessions.
Prayers of intercession. Jesus calls us out of darkness and into his marvellous light. Washed clean by the waters of baptism, let us pray that we may live the life which he has called us. Lord Jesus, eternal word, proclaimed as the Christ by John the Foreigner, hear us as we pray for all who proclaim your word. Lord of truth, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, baptizing with the Spirit and with fire, strengthen us to withstand all the trials of our faith. Lord of truth, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, bringing forgiveness to all who repent, teach your church dependence on your grace. Lord of truth, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, fulfillment of the promises of old, give hope to all who suffer or are ignored. Lord of truth, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, beloved Son of the Father, anoint us with the gifts of your Holy Spirit. Lord of truth, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, bringer of hope, share with all the faithful the riches of eternal life. Lord of truth, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus Christ, in you the Father makes us and all things new. Transform the poverty of our nature by the riches of your grace and the renewal of our lives. Make known your heavenly glory. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Jasmine, for those prayers. We share the peace. God has made us one in Christ. He has set his seal upon us, and as a pledge of what is to come, he has given us the Spirit to dwell in our hearts. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Open the heavens, Holy Spirit, for us to see Jesus interceding for us. May we be willing to share his baptism, ready to share his cup, and strengthened to serve him forever. Amen. The Lord is here. His Spirit is with us. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Lord of all life, you created the universe where all living things reflect your glory. You give us this great and beautiful earth to discover and to cherish. And now we give you thanks because by water and the Holy Spirit, you have made us a holy people in Jesus Christ our Lord. You renew that mystery in bread and wine to show forth your glory in all the world. You made us all, each wonderfully different, to join with the angels and sing your praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We thank you, loving Father, because you sent Jesus, your Son. He gave us his life for us on the cross and shows us the way to live. Send your Holy Spirit, that these gifts of bread and wine may be for us Christ's body and his blood. On the night before he died, when darkness had fallen, Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, broke it, and shared it with his disciples. This is my body, he said, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After they had eaten, he took the cup, gave thanks, and shared wine with his disciples. This is my blood, he said, poured out for you and for all people to save them from their sins. Do this in remembrance of me. Father, with this bread and this cup, we celebrate his love, his death, his risen life. As you feed us with these gifts, send your Holy Spirit and change us more and more to be like Jesus, our Saviour. Help us to love one another and to work together for that day when the whole world is fed, suffering is ended, and all creation is gathered in your loving arms. With all your saints, we give you glory through Jesus Christ in the strength of the Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. Believing the promises of God, as our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body because we all share in one bread. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Let us pray. Lord of all time and eternity, you opened the heavens and revealed yourself as Father in the baptism of Jesus, your beloved Son. By the power of your Spirit, complete the heavenly work of our rebirth through the waters of the new creation, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. We pray together. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. And as we draw to the end of our service, blessing. May God, who in Christ gives us a spring of water welling up to eternal life, perfect in you the image of his glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you and all whom you love this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, Amen.
Everyone needs compassion, a love that's never failing.